Christy, and this is Roughing It Homestead. Today, I'm going to talk about some of the changes that we've been noticing around the homestead with the coming of spring. So we've lived on the homestead for just over 90 days now, and we've survived the winter. We thought we had it rough, but now we've noticed that the road is mud, complete mud from here all the way 2.5 miles down to the main road. So what does that mean for us? That means that we cannot drive down the road. Driving down the road is going to wreck the road and possibly get us stuck and do damage to our equipment, our truck. So it means that we get to spend lots of time here on the homestead. So we're going to talk through kind of some of the provisions that we kind of took and made to be safe and survive the next couple of months of mud season. So we talked with some locals and we came to understand that our road may be impassable for up to 2 months. So we needed to prepare for that amount of time. In order to do that, we have 40 gallons of gasoline for our generator, which powers our electric system. And you can see our previous video about how that system works. 150 gallons of water. And you can see our previous video on water and how we handle that here on our off-grid homestead. And food provisions for 4 months. And most of that is canned goods. So canned meat, canned vegetables, dry goods. We have dry good buckets. And a lot of the stuff we did talk about in a previous video, which I also will link in the cards. But we did spoil ourselves a little. We got a mini fridge, refrigeration. So we are keeping like our condiments and stuff in there once they're open, which is not something we had the luxury of for the past 90 plus days. So that's exciting. So fuel, food, and water. Of course, we have some medical supplies here at the cabin, and I have shot a video about that. I'll leave that in the cards. But there are just some medical things that you can't, that's hard to prepare for. So it just so happens a week into not being able to leave the homestead, I got a cut. And that cut got a bit of infection. So, you know, these are the risks we take. I had to walk out to the main road, the 2 miles, and get a ride into town so that I could go to a doctor and get some antibiotics. So if anyone has a good solution to these kinds of problems, definitely leave that in the comments below. But these are the kind of risks that we take in this lifestyle. So that does bring me to the next point, which is why? Why would we take these risks and live in an off-grid cabin in a remote part of the Upper Peninsula? And that's a great question, one that we get pretty often when we tell people that we left the city and decided to move to an off-grid cabin in the middle of winter. And there's just a certain amount of satisfaction that comes from a life that is of your own making. I believe really strongly in living a sustainable life, and I feel like I get that living off my own land. And we have so many plans for the future. And so that is something that we're going to be working on a lot over the next couple of months while we're stuck here. And we did procure some project materials before being kind of sequestered here at the cabin. So look forward to some videos coming up. We're going to be doing some renovation to our kitchen. We're going to be doing some screening in of our porch and a little bit of rehab on it. We ordered a bunch of trees that we're going to be planting in the late spring. So definitely look forward to these videos coming out over the next couple of months. And we're really excited to bring you along on our journey. Thanks for joining me.